Howdy folks, got another little graph theory proof for you in today's Wrath of Math lesson. We'll be proving that if an edge is a bridge of a graph, then there is a unique path connecting the end vertices of the bridge, and in particular that path is the bridge itself. We only need to consider connected graphs because bridges are defined in terms of connected graphs. Recall that a bridge of a connected graph is an edge that when deleted disconnects the graph. We can speak more generally and say that a bridge of a graph is an edge that when deleted disconnects the connected component that the edge belongs to. So we can sort of broaden that definition to apply to disconnected graphs by zoning in on the connected components. So we only have to consider connected graphs. Let's draw a diagram to help us start discussing the result and its proof. So our graph might look something like this. We've just got these sort of two arbitrary pieces of the graph. We don't know what they look like, but somewhere in the graph is this bridge that we can call E. So I'll put a little dotted line noting that this edge is a bridge. If we delete the edge E, then it disconnects the graph. Of course, it's called a bridge because it's a bridge between these what would be disconnected components of the graph if it wasn't for the bridge. So we want to prove that this is the unique path connecting U and V, the end vertices of the bridge. So of course, the first thing we might do is just point out that there is a path connecting U and V, the end vertices of the bridge. That path, depending on how you write paths, we could just write like this. It's the path going from U to V because they are adjacent vertices. It just takes one step to get from U to V. That is a path connecting them. So then all that remains to be proven is that that is the unique path connecting U and V, which seems, you know, when we draw it with a diagram, it seems pretty obvious. What's useful about this result, I think, is that it tells us that, okay, if we delete the bridge, then its end vertices in particular will be disconnected in the resulting graph. We know that if we delete a bridge, the resulting graph will be disconnected, but this tells us in particular the end vertices of the bridge will be disconnected because the bridge was the unique path connecting those vertices. And we will use this result in a later lesson to prove that if we delete a bridge from a graph, that graph will have exactly two components, and this is going to help us out, which is a big difference from cut vertices. You might recall that you can delete a cut vertex from a graph, and the resulting graph could have a huge number of components. You could go from one component to a million components by deleting a cut vertex, but we're going to use this result later to prove that that's not how it works with bridges. I won't talk too much about that, though, because that's not what we're talking about today. Let's just prove the theorem. I think a pretty clear way we should go about this is by contradiction. Suppose, for the sake of contradiction, that this is not the unique UV path. So suppose that there is some other UV path. That path might look something like this, and we could call it Q. This is just some other UV path in the graph. Now, of course, we're going to be able to show that this is a contradiction because what we're going to demonstrate is that if there is some other UV path, then deleting our bridge E doesn't disconnect the graph, which contradicts the definition of bridge. To help us out in getting that contradiction, we want to notice that this path Q, this hypothetical path Q, cannot contain our edge E. Why not? Well, suppose it did contain the edge E. Suppose it contains E right at the start of the path. Then, so Q starts at U, and then it traverses across the edge E to the vertex V. Well, then it would have to stop immediately because Q is a UV path. So if it starts at this edge going from U to V, it would have to stop immediately, in which case it's just this path and is not, in fact, a different path. The only other possibility would be that it doesn't stop and it keeps on going, but since it stops at V, it would have to come back to V, which would mean it repeats vertices and thus is not a path. On the other hand, if it contains the edge E, but not at the beginning of the path, then again it must repeat vertices, because it would start at U, since it's a UV path, and then at some point down the line, it gets to this edge, which means that it hits the vertex U again, so again it wouldn't be a path. So if Q is another UV path distinct from this one, it can't possibly contain the edge E. Now that's going to be useful. What's so useful about that? Well, if we consider the graph G minus E, so let's quickly note that we're going to call this graph G. If we consider the graph G minus E, this path Q will still exist since it doesn't contain this edge or bridge E. So let me note that real quick. So I just jotted down that our UV path Q, as we discussed, does not contain the edge E, which means it exists in the graph G minus E. Now to get our contradiction, we want to show that G minus E, the graph that we get by deleting this bridge, we want to show this graph is connected, which contradicts this edge being a bridge. How do we show a graph is connected? Pretty straightforward, just using the definition. We just take two arbitrary vertices from G minus E and show there must be a path between them. So we'll say, take two vertices, what should we call them? Let's call them X and Y. Take X and Y from the vertex set of G minus E. These are just two arbitrary vertices. So then there are two possibilities. For starters, we know there is a XY path in the original graph G. So let's just name that path, because the original graph G is connected, so there must be an XY path in G. So let's just name that. We'll say let P be an XY path. Let P be an XY path in G. So it may or may not be in our graph G minus E, but we know this path had to exist in G. All right, so then the two possibilities are that P either contained the bridge that we deleted, or P did not contain the bridge that we deleted. Let's quickly switch colors. How about to green? First possibility, suppose that the path does contain, no, excuse me. First possibility, suppose that the path didn't contain the edge E. So let's just write that here. If our XY path P, if P doesn't contain E, what does that mean if P doesn't contain E? Well, that means that P still exists in G minus E. Thus, certainly, X and Y are connected in G minus E because this path connecting them still exists. Okay, so what about if P does contain the edge E? If P does contain E, then certainly that path does not exist in G minus E because wherever it encountered that edge is now gone. So how can we fix that? The edge was used to either get from U to V or to get from V to U, since those are the vertices that the bridge joins. So we could patch that up if we just replace it with our UV path Q. That's our contradiction assumption, is that this other path exists. And we know it doesn't contain E, so we can just insert it. If P does contain E, then replace it with our UV path Q. So wherever the edge E appeared in our XY path P, wherever the edge E appeared, just replace it with Q. Now, you know, you might have to go from U to V, which would be Q, or you might have to go from V to U, which you might call Q inverse, but I think you get the idea. We can use Q to travel between these two vertices. So then what do we have now? If we replace the edge E in our XY path P with this other UV path Q. So again, that's what the edge E did, was it traveled between U and V. If we don't have E, we can replace it with Q. So what do we have now? We don't know for sure that we have a path, but we definitely have a walk. We definitely have a way to get from X to Y in the graph G minus E. So finally, we finish this long sentence. We say, if P does contain E, then replace E with Q to produce an XY walk. And that's all we need, because it turns out, even though what we've created might not be a path, where there is a walk connecting two vertices, there must be a path. So if there's a walk, then there is also a path. And so X and Y are connected. I'll leave a link in the description to a video I did proving that result, that if there is a walk, then there is a path. Did that quite a while ago. So that's it. Either way, X and Y have to be connected. They were connected in G by this path P. If P doesn't contain E, then it still exists in G minus E, and so X and Y are connected. If P does contain E, Well, E was just used to travel between U and V, so we can replace that with our other path Q to produce an XY walk, thus X and Y are still connected. So every pair of vertices in G minus E is connected, so G minus E is connected, so E is not a bridge, and that's a contradiction because, of course, E was defined to be a bridge. So that's it. Thus, it must be the case that if an edge is a bridge, then there is a unique path connecting its end vertices, which is just traveling across the bridge. And that's it. So I hope this video helped you understand this proof of this little bridge result. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, need anything clarified, or have any other video requests. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time. And be sure to subscribe for the swankiest math lessons on the internet.